Hello, topic for this video is Kirchhoff's laws of electrical network. We have to see how to apply Kirchhoff's laws to an electrical network. There are two such laws. First law, Kirchhoff's current law, short form KCL, or you can even call it as junction rule. Because this law can be applied to junctions, it is also called junction rule. This is the statement of the law. Algebraic sum of currents passing through a junction is zero, or sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to sum of the currents leaving the junction. We will follow the first one. Algebraic sum of currents passing through a junction is zero. First, you have to know what is this algebraic sum. That means some kind of current you will take positive, the other kind of current you will take negative. Meaning, the currents flowing towards the junction you can take positive. So currents entering the junction you can take positive, the current leaving the junction you can take negative. Find algebraic sum, then equate it to zero. Because it is said algebraic sum of currents passing through a junction is zero. This is the circuit for which we are going to apply this KCL. Now see this convention. Currents towards the junction positive, leaving negative. Okay, now we see how to apply this law to some junction here. Let's say we are going to apply it to the junction D. We will apply it for the junction D here. Okay. Algebraic sum of the currents. To this junction, you see this current I is flowing. You can just go like this. So the current I is here. But it is going towards the junction. So positive. Now this I3, you know, it is leaving the junction. So minus I3 according to the convention. Now there is another current here, that is I1. I1 is indicated here, but it is this current only. You can even write here as I. This current is going towards the junction. So I. This is I. This is I3. I think this current is I1. So I1. Okay. So plus I1 is 0. Plus I1 is 0. So this is algebraic sum of the currents passing through the junction is 0. We have applied for the junction D. But you can even apply for the junction A if you want. Say I just applied here. For this junction, this current I, you know, that is going away. So I is like this. So minus I. Minus I. And also for this junction, this I3 is going towards the junction. So plus I3. Okay. Now this current, you know, I1 is leaving this junction. So I1. Then only it can go like this. Okay. This current I1 is coming, leaving this junction and goes like this. So you have to consider that way. So minus I1. Is 0. This is as you apply it at A. Now you see this one and this one. This equation and this equation. Both are same. Now we see how to apply the second law. That means Kirchhoff's voltage law, KVL. KVL is a short form. Full form is Kirchhoff's voltage law. We can also call it as loop rule because you can apply it to loops. Unlike the first law, which you applied for junctions, this you should apply for the entire loop. Loop means closed path, closed circuit. You can apply this. You can't apply KVL for junction. You can apply KVL for the full loop. Loop means the closed path, say B, C, D, A, B, or B, A, D, C, B, anyway. This is a statement of the law. Algebraic sum of changes of potential around any closed circuit is 0, or closed path is 0, or closed loop is 0. You can say anyway. Here also changes of potential, here also algebraic sum, then changes of potential here. Changes of potential, what do you mean by changes of potential? So change of potential here for us in our case includes EMF values. The EMF values can be considered as change of potential. Also, the potential drop across resistances.
the product of current and resistance, the IR term, that is also change of potential. So we encounter two kinds of change of potentials in our cases, right? Algebraic sum. So we should consider particular kind of change of potential positive, then the other kind of change of potential negative. We have to follow the convention. What is the convention? For applying the convention, you have to trace the loop. Trace means you start from one corner, go around the loop, come back to the same corner, meaning start from B, from B go to C, from C go to D, from D go to A, and then back to B. You have to trace, right? You can even trace this way also. The tracing can be either clockwise or anti-clockwise. It's better you indicate it which way the circuit is traced. Here it is indicated clockwise, the tracing. If you trace it, you may encounter resistance while you are tracing, you know, in the path. Here in BC you are not encountering any specific thing. BC there is no resistance, there is no battery, so nothing dramatic here. So you go from B to C, nothing happens. But when you go from C to D, there is a resistance, right? So you will have to apply convention following this. Whenever you encounter resistance and EMFs, you will apply convention. So here it says, while tracing a circuit, if in any resistance the direction of current is same as that of tracing, then the PD across that resistance, that is IR term, is negative, otherwise positive. And while tracing a loop, if one has to go from positive to negative of a cell within the cell, then that EMF you will have to take negative, otherwise positive. We see how to apply the law here. For that we have to take closed circuit, closed path. We take the path, this closed path we will take, that is this one. We start from B, go like this. This is tracing, okay? Go like this, go like this, and go like this. And the direction of current, you consider this R1 now first. Direction of current in R1 is this way. Direction of tracing, direction of current in R1 is same. So minus IR1. Now continue tracing. You have finished R1, now you continue tracing like this. When you trace, and R2 is there, and this current is in this is I3 and direction of tracing, I3 and the direction of circuit, right? Direction of I3 and direction of tracing are same. So minus I3 R2. Why minus? Direction of current, direction of tracing are same in R2. Then continue tracing. When you come here, you encounter a cell. You are going from negative to positive of the cell, because you have to cross this and then only you can reach B, no? So going from negative to positive of the cell, that is plus. EMF is plus, so plus V1. This has to be taken 0. Algebraic sum has to be taken 0. So I write here separately minus IR1 minus I3R2 plus V1 is 0. Okay, this is how you apply for this loop, BD for this loop, okay, BC, DAB. But you see, you can even multiply the whole equation by minus 1, because if you do not start with the negative symbol here, you know what you can do, you just see, when you multiply the whole equation by minus 1, just for convenience, you can write the same equation as IR1 plus I3R3 minus V1 is equal to 0. Okay, either this or this, anything is fine when you want to solve equations. Now we can see how to apply this for the other loop, say A, F, E, D, A. We apply it now. It is shown here in the anti-clockwise direction. We apply it for the loop A, F, E, D, A. Apply it to this loop. So you start from A. you go from A to F, nothing happens because there is no resistance, there is no battery. So nothing happens. Simply you will have to trace. Then from M to E, from F to E when you go, you meet a resistance. In this resistance, this current is same as the direction of tracing. You are tracing like this. Don't forget. Direction of current I1. Direction of current I1 is same as direction of tracing. So minus I1 R3. Then after you have gone now from F to E, then you have to go from E to D. In that you are encountering a battery. You are going from positive to negative of the battery. Battery here cell. Okay? So that has to be taken negative V2 according to the convention. Then after reaching D, you will have to go back to the same point, you know. When you go back to A, you are encountering a resistance here, R2. Current is I3. Note that you are tracing like this. Anti-clockwise direction. So your direction of tracing and the direction of current, they are same. So minus I3 R2. This is algebraic sum of changes of potential equated to zero. So I just write it here separately, just for convenience sake. Okay. So here I will write minus I1 R3 minus V2 minus I3 R2 is 0. Okay. You can even change it because everything is minus here. No, here also minus, here minus. So you just change. Multiply the whole thing by minus 1. So it becomes I1 R3 plus V2 plus I3 R2 is 0. This is how we will apply for this group. A, F, E, D, U. Right? So you have got three equations you got. This is one equation. This is another equation, equation 2. This is another equation. So if the resistance values and the EMF values are given, you can find out I3, I1. I think I didn't take any I2 here. I simply took this as I, this I3, this is I1. So it doesn't matter. Okay. So this is how it goes. Any difficulty? Right? Thank you.